Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome to my another video series on Android app development. So guys, in this series I will teach you how to integrate and how to use the Mapbox API or Mapbox SDK in your Android application. Alright, so let's get started. So first of all, let's create a new project, Mapbox tutorial. Alright, and I will click on next, and we will select the empty activity and we click on finish. Alright. So guys, in this video we will only integrate the Mapbox SDK in our Android Studio project. So as you guys can see, we have this project now. First of all, what we need to do is we need to change the constant layout to relative layout, and here we need to remove that. After that, what we need to do is we need to go to our build.gradle file. In here there is a constant layout, we don't need this dependency, so we will remove that. And first of all, the first step is you have to create an account on Mapbox website. So you just write Mapbox, and when you open the Mapbox, okay, so here you have to click on get started. Alright, it's taking some time. So after that, let me open it again. So here after creating your account, you will have a default public token. Okay, so you have to first of all copy that. I don't know why it's not working, mapbox.com. I think my internet is very slow. So after that, what here you have to open the link. I will paste the link in the video description. So now here it's so first of all, what we need to do is we need to add the dependency. Alright, so we just copy that and paste it in our build.gradle, and we click on sync now. There we have all the code they have provided us, like let me show you. First of all, let's see if we get the error or if the dependency is integrated to our project or not. So let's see. In the meanwhile, let's add the user permissions. So here we add the permissions as user permission internet. We need the permission, and also we need the permission of access network state, and we need the permission access file location. Alright, so it's taking a lot of time because my internet is very slow. So guys, the integration is now completed. So now what we need to do is let's go to our main activity Java file. Here first of all, we need to integrate or initialize the Mapbox API. So for that, we can say here Mapbox dot get instance, and in here we need to pass the reference, and here we need to paste our access token. So we can get our access token from here. We copy that and we paste it here. After that, we first of all let's initialize the map view. So here let's change it to match parent and match parent. Alright. And here we need to specify the ID map 1. Okay. So now in our main activity dot java file, here we need let's initialize the map view and let's first of all let's copy that, cut that and paste it. Above the set content view, and here first of all need to initialize the map view. Alright, now the next step is we need to implement the method, override the method, sorry, on start, on stop, on pass, on resume, on load, maybe. Alright, and we just say method.on start, similarly, method.on stop, similarly map view dot on resume, resume and map view dot on your memory. Alright, so guys, in this way we can initialize our map box, or you can say we can integrate the map box SDK in our Android project. So in my that video, I will teach you how to add the markers and how to display the map. Alright, so if you like the video, please subscribe. Thank you. Goodbye.